The 2025 model year is most likely the last year when you can buy the 3.8-liter GDI engine called the G6DN in the Hyundai Palisade. The next generation will have the newer 3.5-liter V6, which is pretty much different from the current 3.8-liter option. So this is the V6 engine used in only two vehicles, the Palisade and also the Kia Telluride. It's the Lambda 2 family of engines that has a pretty long history and is overall considered quite reliable. Interestingly, this engine works in the Atkinson cycle, which means pistons move up faster than they move down. This adds to the fuel economy, but requires very high compression. The engine is equipped with the timing chain, all camshafts have a variable valve timing system, and there are no hydraulic lifters, which may lead to a quite expensive service procedure of valve clearance adjustment. The GDI index in the name of this engine means that it has a direct injection and its intake valves tend to get clogged with carbon buildup over time. But this is a common problem for all GDI engines, and fortunately mechanics now have skills and equipment to clean those valves pretty easily. Even though the previous generations of the V6 Lambda 2 engines had serious problems with timing chains, the G6DN model does seem to be better in this. The chain doesn't elongate and doesn't rattle up until very high mileage. But anyway, I would have a close look at the chain and the tensioner at about 120,000 miles or 200,000 kilometers just to make sure it's okay. The engine does seem to run with certain vibrations. I believe this is connected with intake valve contamination and valve clearance problems, but vibration problems seem to be pretty common and owners report it on every forum. Also, oil consumption is a big problem. These engines start drinking up oil at very low mileage and the consumption may be about 1 quart or 1 liter for every 1,000 miles, and this is considered normal. I think the problem is with the weak piston rings, but you should also keep an eye on possible oil leaks. Part of the 2023 model year engines were subjected to a recall due to valve springs being damaged during assembly. That's not a huge problem and only a few engines were affected, but if your vehicle is a 2023 model year, it makes sense to check it using your VIN on the Hyundai official website. Overall, this is a pretty good and reliable engine with just a few complaints on the internet. It's not fuel efficient at all, being a big V6 unit, and it's not super powerful with 291 horsepower. Also, the good thing is that it's only equipped with the 8-speed conventional automatic transmission, which is probably not the best unit in the world, but anyway, a good choice for this heavy vehicle. The 3.8-liter engine is good, but not problem-free, and it wants you to know its common issues to do something to prevent them from happening, since the repairs may cost you thousands, even if it's something small failing in this engine. But if serviced well, the V6 will last for quite a long time with little to no problems.